January 2008, Water1st staff and a group of water tour participants traveled to Ethiopia. On our first day of touring project sites in the Oromia region, we were fortunate to take part in the inauguration ceremonies for the Water1st Alamamuja Water Project. More than 500 people were on hand to celebrate the culmination of 18 months of hard work. At 2 p.m. on January 14th, water officially began to flow from the new taps constructed with funds provided by Water1st. Speeches, dances, and a huge feast marked the ceremonies.
Just even the pictures that I see, like the UN or groups will go in and drop stuff off. This feels a lot different to me. It feels very much owned by the people.
Yes, there's money coming from the West, but what's really happening is people taking the time to teach them how to use the power that they already have to make things better for their children and generations to come.
We then traveled to the communities of Bishikiltu. When this project was originally proposed to Water1st, it was more than we could afford. As a result, we had to postpone the Bishikiltu project. However, thanks to the incredible generosity of our donors in 2007, we were able to raise enough money to commit to it. Water Action, our local partner organization, had kept the good news to themselves, wanting Water1st to be the ones to deliver it to the people of Bishikiltu.
I feel very lucky to be able to be here with you and to give you this news in person, especially because we believe that by visiting here, you really strengthened us to be able to go home and do the work that we needed to do. So I thank you for that.
Today we are reborn. We will do whatever it takes to make this project happen. We are poor, but we will work hard.
What you see in my hand is drinking water. We drink this water, we wash with this water, we cook with this water.
It's dirty and it's hard to get.
We know that we are different people. You have light skin and we have dark skin, but you still care for us from halfway around the world. Now we know that we have not been forgotten.
I feel like you come here and you kind of join in on something together. I mean, they did all the work. I didn't do any of this work, but I know that I was a partner in it. So it felt like this is possible. I feel like I've touched hope, and I don't think that we touch hope all that often.